So in this lesson, I'm going to talk about why you should bother about infrastructure as a code tools. And I'm going to talk about six main points here. Number one being the scale. Now, if you were a system administrator in probably 70s and 80s, would have been managing probably a handful of servers, and the churn rate was pretty low. So you set up the servers, provision those, install the operating systems, and use it like almost forever. Now we're talking about virtual machines and cloud. And with cloud, we are talking about a massive infrastructure that we have to build and manage. And the churn rate, it is pretty high as well. So talking about, let's say, elasticity that cloud offers, you would be creating servers all the time and destroying those on demand, based on the need, based on the scale that you would want, based on the demand on in terms of the request and so on. So it's the auto-scalable, elastic infrastructure and a massive infrastructure in general, because we are talking about now big data and analytics and AI and mobile and whatnot in general, right? So we are not managing handfuls of servers anymore. We are talking about a much larger scaled infrastructure. And that also requires you as a DevOps practitioner to manage a much larger scale of infrastructure. And that's exactly what the infrastructure as a code tools, automation tools such as, let's say, Ansible and Terraform, and there are a bunch of other tools which would help you manage it at ease, or with ease rather. And you can scale yourself to manage thousands and thousands of servers with probably the same amount of time. So the scale is one big point. The second point that I want to talk about is consistency. And that's probably what drew me initially to these automation tools back in 2007, right? Because at that point of time, I was part of an operations team managing an infrastructure as a team. So we were few people in India and few people in US, and everybody would come, we would work in a timeshare basis. And let's say I would come in my day, take over the infrastructure, start making changes, managing it. And most of that, you know, the changes that we made or things that we did on top of our servers in terms of application, installation, configurations, change management were done by hand or sometimes with scripts. Now, with that approach, we ended up using or having these snowflake servers where nobody knew exactly what is the current state of that server and the application on that server and the configurations and so on. It was a big, hot mess. And that's when I started with my first automation tool in 2007, which was Puppet. Then I took to Chef as well, and then I picked up Ansible back, you know, around 2014. And, you know, it's just different tools with different approaches, but you definitely need a tool which helps you automate your infrastructure so that you can bring in consistency. And with these tools, you are guaranteed to know that, oh, you exactly know what is the state of your infrastructure across your servers, because you pretty much manage it through a centralized management system. And that brings us to the third point here. That is, the centralized management system is what you get with infrastructure as a code tool. So you typically write everything using a declarative code, store it as a code on one server that acts as your master or your controller node in case of, let's say, Ansible. And from there, you push, or the nodes pull the configuration. In either ways, you have one place to push your, to write and push the configurations to. And from there, it gets propagated to your system, whichever way it may be, right? And the good thing about that is then you're not connecting to these many, let's say I have thousands of servers and I don't have to go to each of these individual servers. I would rather write the code and push it to just one node. And that also helps me save some time. So that's another point I want to make, is with these tools, these automation tools, which help you write your infrastructure as a code, push it to one centralized system, and from there propagate to all your environment, it makes it much easier to do anything with the less amount of time, right? Because I may be managing like 5 nodes, or in 6 months' time, it could be 500 nodes. I can scale from 5 to 500, but the efforts that I would need and the time I would need to spend in order to build that infrastructure, manage it, is almost the same, right? Because we automate everything. You write the code once, test it once, and you're pretty much done. You can use it multiple times, right? And that brings me to the next point, that is ability to recreate or reproducible code, basically. Since you're writing everything as code, you can take that code and build an infrastructure with the same state anywhere else, right? It could be a different environment. Let's say I tested it in my dev, and then I want to recreate the same setup, maybe at a much larger scale, in staging or in production environment. It's absolutely possible to do that with the same code, because one of the fundamental things that all of these tools, it could be Ansible, Terraform, Jenkins file, whatever you call it as infrastructure as a code, it allows you to templatize things. So once you templatize things, you provide the data at the time of running it. So you can have a different profile for dev and stage and prod, and run it, with the same code with different profiles, and you can get the configurations done very quickly. So ability to recreate, reproduce the same code or same infrastructure out of the code is pretty useful to have. And that not only helps you to manage different environments, but also help you when you want to migrate. Let's say you're on a data center environment and you want to migrate to cloud, or if you're on a cloud and you want to migrate to another cloud or have a hybrid cloud setup, it is very easy to do if you have written that everything as code, so that you can take just your code repository, provision some servers or infrastructure, and you're good to go, right? So that's another point. So next point I want to make is, and this is like really my favorite, once you start using tools like Ansible, Chef, Puppet, Terraform, whatever qualifies as infrastructure as a code, most of these tools give you a readily available code. There's a library of code. Let's say I want to deploy some generic applications like Apache or PHP or Python or Node.js, or it could be any other modern application, including the big data and AI and whatnot, right? Now, most of the time, I don't have to write the code from scratch, because since it's all code and you can make it generic, there is a library of generic code available. Let's say I want to deploy Apache web server in my environment. I don't have to even worry about writing the code for it using, let's say, Ansible, because I can go to the library, I can pull the code, I can add just my data, and that's what I care about, or that's what I would probably need to know initially, and then get my configurations done. So you can actually reuse a lot of code, so your efforts are saved, your time is saved, right? And those are some of the advantages of using infrastructure as a code tools, and that's why you should care about it.